then his whole team got wins and the world's spinning. I told him what I told him. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down, I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dumb?
Tonight on EA Sports. Super Bowl 59. Super Bowl 59. Wishing he had a mulligan. That's not how you want to start the game.
Not at all, because not only do you give up the penalty and...
Put my wrist on freeze. take another L. Designer on me, this they new Chanel. Did they splash? Did they drill? Yeah, yeah, champion, yeah, we here.
Super Bowl 59, fielded near the back of the end zone. And we will not have a return, so the first drive of the Super Bowl will begin at the 25. Jackson fakes the give and keeps it. And whoa, he's going to hope that that is not a sign of things to come. A rude welcoming to this ball game.
Well, sometimes that option can get bogged down before the gears really even get into motion, and I think that's what we saw there.
And I think what he saw defensive end right in his face because he looked up and he was right there. Didn't even have a chance to get going.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Now it's Jackson. He's going to float this one deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. And great yardage here all the way deep into Los Angeles territory. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
And he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there on a first down again.
Well, part of why that play works is because the defense has to freeze because they don't know whether he's going to hand it off or keep it himself. And this time, how about that sleight of hand there? Gives it to his wideout. And that indecision defensively, boy, it hurt him in a big way.
No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Second and goal.
Turn to a power game to try to get in. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point up and good by Succa. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Rams nothing. Tucker McCann.
McCann's got it teed up. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
On the ground, this is Joe Mixon. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude, and you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, What do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to, and he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who've been there before. Find out how they handle winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things, and then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team their best chance to win.
On third down, Love. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
It's taken to the 26. Going to be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. They're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
7-yard line.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Ravens get a new set of downs, give them 17 on that pickup.
Partner, in our years together, we've never really run into a player that's admitted a doubt or a lack of confidence, right? But right now, I'm just wondering about that interior line, because on defense, they're starting to get manhandled at the point of attack. Do they have it in them to figure a way to reverse the tide? Because right now, they're running the ball at will.
He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of the Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down.
First and 10 at the 13-yard line.
And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Sliding out of the pocket. And that'll be incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made him kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up 1st and 10. Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
A gain of 9 brings up 2nd and 1.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here's 2nd and 1 yard from the 34. Now Joe Mixon. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
That's good for an L.A. Rams. 1st and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. 10-0 the score after 1 on EA Sports.
Rams nothing.
Off the play fake, Love. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there the moment the ball gets to the receiver. And he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
On second down, here's Mixon. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
On third down, Love. He'll get this into the hands of Van Jefferson. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Working out of the gun, Love. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Derek Nnadi makes the tackle.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second and 9, Jackson, he sets to fire deep. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
On third down, Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down. They snap it at 1. Now it's Jackson. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. To throw again. Jackson, he's going to air one out. And all the way in for the Ravens touchdown. Well, you know, he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
You know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. That's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long, man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Tucker McCann set to kick off.
McCann's got it teed up. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down,
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. It's Mixon on the counter. Good move at the 30. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Joe Mixon.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he is going to have a Rams first down by a couple of yards as they're able to get four there on third and two. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon. That catch good for only a couple. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Well, this one to his tight end out on the right side. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. 2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. To throw on third down, Love going up top for Kupp. And that will be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
An attempt at a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They have to be pleased with the way that they've moved the football thus far.
And why wouldn't they be? Two touchdowns on a field goal in their first three possessions. They're playing so well right now, the field goal probably feels like a disappointment.
Now he dumps this off over the middle. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. They go play action now. Jackson throwing right, and that's complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And they run the option here on first and 10. Jackson going to throw quickly here, complete. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. Second and 12 now at the 44-yard line. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 19. A good pick up there, 26 yards. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Incomplete. He was defended by James.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Jackson firing quickly here, and that's complete. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. That last catch winds up costing him three, so now they'll need to convert on third and 13. And Jackson throwing once more. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
Intended for Mark Andrews. Incomplete.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. He connected on his first. This time it's 39 yards away. And in his 15th season, he's able to get this one to go. And the lead now increases to 20 to nothing. So a capper there to a pretty good first half.
And I love the way that they put a chokehold on the clock and pretty much drained everything before they put the field goal on the board as they headed into the half.
4 seconds, all that remain here in this first half as the kick gets away. Taking it about the one. And he's only going to get this to the 4-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 4-yard line. I got homies that can speak without two. I got homies.
Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. He'll take the knee, and the final couple seconds will tick by in this first half. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, these two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on 2nd and 12. Play fake. Here's Love. Oh, going for Jefferson down. And the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, LA. Van Jefferson. 77 yards. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Max Crosby, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Now after that sack, it's 3rd and long for Jackson and the Ravens. Jackson from the shotgun. Forced out to his left. And they'll get him down right around the 11-yard line. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th.
And, partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's 3rd down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
Let's take it inside his own 40. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Third quarter of the biggest spectacle in sport, the Super Bowl. Thanks for joining us, everybody. 2nd and 10. They'll run with Mixon, and he'll take this one down to the 36. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. Love from the gun. And that is incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And that will get the disadvantage now back down to 11. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration. Now, seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their own 21. And he'll give it here to his running back. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24.
Micah Kaiser on the
tackle. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
A gain of 13, it's a first down. Going to give this time to the tailback. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Brings up 2nd and 8.
And now Jackson will look to throw it. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Jackson's
he caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. It's hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His 2nd catch in the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down. From the gun, Jackson. Buying time to his left. He's going to take off with it. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up 2nd down.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
Play action. Now Jackson eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, 3rd down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Jackson now to throw on 3rd down. Throw left side, going to be taken in by Harris. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. 1 quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Right, call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is 1st and goal. They'll try to run it in, going option right. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain there as he kept it himself at 2nd down.
Leads to 2nd and goal at the 8-yard line.
From the gun, it's Jackson. That is caught at the 7-yard line. Jackson. Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. He may try and run for this. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a fourth down. This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put 6 on the board.
So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it's still 8 up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Their own 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And we're at the time of the Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly. Trailing here in the 4th quarter as they begin this drive 1st and 10. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. That's just his 2nd catch of the game. They wanted to keep him silent. They have kept him silent.
Defensive football 101. Don't let the best player on offense beat you. Take him out of the game. And they've done a great job of doing that.
Love now to pass on 1st down. Goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. They couldn't contain Deshaun Hand that time as he gets home for the sack. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you get 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
2nd down, Love. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Third and long for Love. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on 4th down. Desperation time here. Love on 4th down. And no, it's incomplete. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on 4th down. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape.
It's a turnover on downs.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. Rolling to his right. He's going to take off with it. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Now that was not a bad scramble there on 1st down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Jackson flush to his right. Now he'll pull it down. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs. Able to improvise and get the first.
1st and 10 at the 13-yard line.
Two minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so they didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
Another running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now a handoff looking right. And not even back to the line of scrimmage this time as they're on him quickly once more. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So they'll turn to the kicker again. He's been a busy man thus far. This to make it a three-score game late. Suckup's kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to 17. So with that, you figure, yeah, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though? 25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like a distant memory as they have been outplayed tonight. He was looking for Joe Mixon there out of the backfield. And now it's second down. Throw again. Love. He'll find Everett there, complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down. He's got this one completed to Mims. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. Again, it's Love. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Alex Anzalone drops him for a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down.
And it's fourth down.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. Looking for Mims, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple.
And don't worry about it, baby.
To the races, down the right side. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. What a moment for him, a pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember, because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that would pretty much sealed the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison of the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended? That was a big-time play. But for me, the absolute classic, Willie Brown in slow motion. Against the Vikings for the Raiders. The grand old man, Willie Brown, 75 yards.
You recall them all. And what a play here. Another pick six in the Super Bowl. Love back to it here after the pick six. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So he hooked up with a veteran there, and in overtime, that's not a bad idea. Go with the age and the experience.
Yeah, because sometimes the young guys, they give you the fresh legs and give you all that bounce. But in this type of a situation, sometimes those legs slow down a little bit as the enormity of the moment overwhelms them. The veteran guys, they tend to come through.
And it's all over. Just one is left standing, and that one is the Baltimore Ravens, your Super Bowl champions. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.